What's going on, guys? This is going to be a review for Chapter 179 of Vinland Saga. We have finally reached fucking Vinland! How crazy is that? How crazy is it that we're actually at Vinland now, which is, of course, North America? And as a resident of North America, I can say, you're not really missing out on much. So yes, the long-awaited journey has finally come to an end. Thankfully, we did not have to be on a boat arc for 50 chapters or more. My cat's pushing on the door to come in. Come on! Come on! Come here! Ashes, you want to be in the video? Yes, you do! Yes, you want to be in the video. Say hi to my audience. No, you're too cute. They'll leave me for you. Get out of here. Anyways, Vinland Saga. Chapter 179, we finally get to Vinland. I'm really glad that they kind of did the boat trip very quickly, and we didn't have to linger on that for a long time. The last chapter was played up pretty much more for humor, and to kind of like get more of the ancient myths and mythologies of the time out there, a little bit of a recap on that. For the most part, I mean, that chapter was what it was. It was pretty much just a buffer in between leaving for Vinland and getting to Vinland. Perhaps Makoto didn't want to just immediately kind of shift one from one chapter to all of a sudden being on Vinland, but this is where the core meat of the story is going to happen, and I'm glad, like I said, we're not going to have some sort of boat arc story. So we finally touch down in Vinland in North America. Now this chapter is pretty much a setup chapter, what I would say. There wasn't anything kind of crazy happening here, despite actually being in Vinland, like I said. But besides that, this is pretty much just letting us know the score. This is letting us know the setup of what's about to happen here. First, they land in an area where, and I'm actually really glad that they did this, that they used Einar, the character that knows all about farming, that basically taught Thorfinn everything he knows about farming, that we need fields a lot bigger than the area where they landed. People land and they think, oh, this is going to be great. Let's set up. Let's start, you know, harvesting and everything. And Einar is like, you don't understand. If we want to make this a habitat for people to actually live in, we need big areas. We need grand pastures and everything. So Thorfinn comes up with a great idea to use that area as sort of like a meeting ground, a middle ground, a trading area, and then move further down south to get to bigger areas of land where they could actually farm. So some of the people are going to be staying at the first area where they departed, and the rest of them are kind of moving on to a different area. And it all leads towards Thorfinn thinking like a strategist, like a warrior, like a fighter that he was before. It's something about him that he'll never be able to discard. In everything that he does in life, he's going to be thinking with that sort of mentality. And it's a good thing that he does, because he's thinking full spectrum. He's thinking about the entire picture, not just one step at a time. He's not letting it go for take it for granted that he arrived at Vinland and now everything's going to be perfect. He knows that things are going to be difficult at first. He knows that he's completely unaware of what could happen in the future, and so he's trying to do this to the best of his possible ability, and thankfully he does have the people around him, such as Gudrid and such as Hild and everybody, to kind of help him out with these particular areas that he might not be the best at. We also get a little bit more set up with the characters that were smuggling swords aboard the ship, talking behind Thorfinn's back, probably going to betray him at some point inevitably, or start a war with the inhabitants of the continent. And that's where the big reveal comes with this chapter. And this was something I was very curious about, and I'm still widely curious about how Makoto is going to handle this particular situation. So as they go further south and they depart again, they do find a hut that probably belonged to either Leif Erikson or, you know, one of the settlers from a long time ago. And within embedded in the hut, Thorfinn finds an arrow. And this is specifically the design of an arrow of a native from Native Americans. So this is obviously a setup of the Native Americans. They are here, obviously, and they might not take too kindly of these people moving in and wanting to live here their own way and do things their own way, when the natives already have their own setup and their own system of life. So this is going to be a crazy pairing when we get these two groups to finally meet each other, and I'm really wondering how they're going to handle the topic of the Native Americans in Vinland Saga. Obviously, you cannot portray them as just straight up savages that want war, but you also can't portray them as these 100% peaceful people. I mean, there's gonna be some sort of middle ground here, and I don't know how far with the realism that Makoto is going to try to present these characters, but it's a risky thing, and I'm glad that he's going to do it. I'm glad he's going to delve into it. because there's a lot of kind of mixed and meshed history with it, especially in my country, in America, because a lot of the horrible shit that happened was covered up. But also, I mean, no group of people is 100% peaceful, right? There's always going to be problems, especially when you're dealing with two different cultures and two people that can't even speak the same language, that look different, their skin are different colors. Like, there's going to be animosity here at first between these characters, and it's going to be a question of how Thorfinn can quell this with, one, the language and culture barrier, but then also not having weapons to defend themselves whatsoever. So Thorfinn going to kind of come to a realization that perhaps his worldview is a little bit too far in one direction, he should pull it back a little bit, or is he just going to double down and just walk out there, you know, with no weapons like he's done before, except now he's not even going to be able to communicate with them. I mean, what's the most he could do, you know, hold out his hand and just try to present himself as not a threat? But even so, these lands don't belong to him, and he wants to set up this perfect, you know, unified world of Vinland, and he might not have it as easy as he thinks. Now, not that he thinks it's going to be easy, but this is going to be... I'm extremely curious about how this whole situation is going to be handled. I couldn't imagine that the series would go through and there wouldn't be any confrontation whatsoever between the natives, especially with these people on board that are looking to kind of stab Thorfinn in the back the first chance that they get, and with Thorfinn being weaponless and everything. But I think just the ominous warning itself of finding the arrow is sort of a prelude into the impending fight that could possibly happen between these characters. It is going to be a risky thing, but I do hope he delves into it pretty hardcore, and I would like to see how this confliction in between these two groups that I really don't know too much about as far as like actual history goes meeting as to what their encounters were possibly like. So I'm very, very curious to see what happens moving forward. I think the truth is confrontation is inevitable, and as much as you don't want to face it, as much as you want to ignore it, eventually the world is going to hit you smack dab in the face, and I believe that this is going to happen to Thorfinn coming up in the near future of these chapters. We're getting a lot of setup chapters now, and we're going to see how far we can push Thorfinn's philosophy, or at least that's what I believe that the intention of this arc will wind up being. And yeah, I don't know. I do believe at the end of the chapter, Thorfinn, upon seeing the arrow, chose to move even further south, I believe, into Vinland. So he's trying to get away from an area that would cause him confrontation, but you can only run from confrontation for so long in life. I do think that all of these are setup chapters that I said in the beginning of this arc, I felt like Vinland Saga was kind of going downhill, along with the fact that I didn't really care too much of how the last arc ended. I liked the last arc as a whole, I just thought the ending was a bit lacking and there were some, you know, some thematic things there that I wish played out more, but didn't really get a chance to. As we're moving into this, I think this is really going to test Thorfinn's philosophy and his decision to not bring weapons, or his decision to try to handle everything peacefully. Anyways, guys, so if you read Vinland Saga Chapter 179, what did you think about it? Are you happy that we're finally in Vinland? What do you think about the characters that are going to betray Thorfinn at some point? And what do you think is going to happen with this confrontation if we get a confrontation between the natives and between Thorfinn's crew? Do you think it's going to go down in a chaotic way? Or do you think he actually will manage to find some sort of peace between them and be able to settle things without violence, like the way he wants to? Personally, I'm not sure if that's possible, but we will see moving forward. So let me know what you thought, guys. Leave your comments, thoughts, and theories down below about what's going to happen in Vinland Saga moving forward. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'd really do appreciate it. Please give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, because it does help out in the algorithm, as long as a comment down below as well. If you like what you saw, consider subscribing to the channel. I do other manga reviews and other stuff. There's a bunch of videos you can check out if you want to, if you got the free time. I would very much appreciate it. So other than that, guys, thank you very much for watching. Hope you have a wonderful day. I'll talk to you next time.